between these two fighters should be a good one. I'm Todd Grisham. And next to me for the broadcast, the one and only Johnny Nelson.
It's action night.
Time for our tale of the tape. Rocky Marciano. He's 5'10" tall, one of the greatest heavyweights to ever live. Rocky. The Gypsy. Much pre-hype surrounding this fight, the fans are on the edge of their seats.
It's so hot, so heat, but there's a roof on here, you don't understand it. When you're working, when the noise is there, the pressure's on, you're thirsty, you're sweating, and you're getting under, you're on the wrong side of a beat. This can be a high fire.
Changes, judge is going to have a tough job. He threw the hook, didn't land.
Opponent before he gets his fist back.
today.
Precision shot. team. Some prices are just different. Movement, they are just, they are the chosen few.
Not to the senses of combat.
he misses with that jab.
Thank you.
significant speed advantage, you can tell who it is.
You have a fire that's got great footwork and great high speed. It's so hard, it's an uphill battle.
Despite what the judges' scorecards mean, there are no losers in this one.
The ring can be the loneliest place in the world.
Thank you. to the 12.
Fatigue is setting in. Let's see how they handle it during this round. Welcome to the WBC Arena, and what a night and what a fight we expect this to be. I'm Todd Grisham. Alongside me is Johnny Nelson.
The pleasure's always mine, my friend.
It's time for our tale of the tape. Deontay Wilder, he is the Bronze Bomber, 6'7" tall with that massive 83-inch reach. And he'll be taking on, yes indeed, Muhammad Ali. He stands 6'3" tall. Here he comes. He is one of the hottest tickets around. These two fighters promised us an offensive show. Let's see if they deliver. He blocks the jab. He fails to score with that left hook. Keep an eye on this slugger. As you know, he's willing to take three to give one. That's his game plan, and it's worked out pretty well for him so far.
Speed generates power. Timing is everything. If you've got speed, you can pack anybody out. You just gotta hit him.
Have had their moments.
He blocks the hook.
He misses with that jab. Left counterpunch to score. Insane action. What a world championship fight this game, ladies and gentlemen. That's counter school. Very competitive rundown with 10 seconds left. See if we can turn it around here.
Now he knows he's been hurt. He's gonna come out and put the pressure on. He's gonna throw the kitchen sink at you. You've got to be ready for that. Don't fight fire with fire. Hold him off. Be smart, because he's gonna try and put you under pressure. He knows your legs are gone. He knows your head's not cleared. Be sharp.
Can tell he's stronger, but he's not faster. Neither man really defending himself. Punch, counter punch. Counter left hand there. As the smaller weight classes in the heavyweight division, but we don't care. We want the heavy fists.
Because they're so big, because they can punch, because they've got the weight behind them, they may not be connected. Just when they get that kick from this 5 second time, because someone's going to get hurt, and someone's going to win.
Momentum going. through the hook, didn't land. Hoffman stepped back for just a moment.
Those situations, you've just been hurt, you better get out there again. Be smart, be sharp. Put your feet, you don't get sucked in. Make you fight, you'll fight. Hold the time up, just until your head clears again. And you let him fight again. Because if you don't, he's gonna pop you off.
It is official now, and that is not the way anyone wanted this fight to end. No complaints there at all. The crowd agree, I agree. The ref knew exactly what he was doing. So you know what? Great shout. I look forward to fight number two. I'm Todd Grisham, and not a bad day for a fight. We are live at the Empire Fight Camp. Next to me, of course, is Johnny Nelson.
It's going to be unbelievable. The fans, everybody around the world, the fighters. This is just one of those things.
It's time now for our tale of the tape. The one and only is the... Usually you don't need a weather report. High hopes for this battle between these two athletes. He just listened to that big right hand. Counter left hand there. Round was a nightmare. Let's see if we can turn it around here.
That was a tough last round. Now you've got to make sure he doesn't put on it. That's what he's going to try and do. So tie him up, hold him, lean on him. Don't get drawn into a fight. Not yet. Not until your senses have come back.
They have no respect for each other's punching power. Here from both men. You'd like to see this fighter protect themselves a little better. A very competitive round here so far. Both of these men showing exceptional chins, by the way. The glory division. There's nothing quite like a heavyweight fight. It doesn't take much to win it.
I've seen it so many times. One punch changes everything. I've seen guys winning hands down. They decide to showboat and show off them. Bang! It's over. But it's got to stay sharp. One punch changes everything.
And he just missed with that left jab. Very competitive round with 10 seconds left. They got the momentum, they got the advantage. How do they carry on to the third? Now, there's no doubt about who won that last round. Let's see what he has for us here in the next one. Thank you. uppercuts a point. They'll hit you 1,000 times before you can land one.
Let me stay to you. That's got hand speed and finish. In a split second, they've got four shots scored. Their footwork has got them out of the way. And these guys are so relaxed. And that's why they can maintain this all the way to a five.
Again, and your legs come back again, because if you don't, he's gonna pop you off.
There's a big difference between being the aggressor and the effective aggressor. Which type have we seen so far?
How do you deal with an aggressive fighter? What do you do if you fight fire with fire? You either give it and back with the fight, or you play it.
Seems like aggression has been the key. This fight is just not slowing down. Halfway through the round, I'm not sure who's winning it. And Joe Lewis is hurt. He is hurt.
I thought we were going to see the finish there.
Something special. This fighter needs to turn the tables in this next round. Raise the bell to start round five. After that last round, something has got to change.
They've had 1 minute to recover. Now they've got to bluff it. They've got to bluff it. They've got to come out now and style it out. Get on the back foot. Jab. Rest on the jab. Be smart and pump until your legs come back. Then put the pressure.
They are.
It's going to be courageous when you're getting in there with some of that bigger, stronger, and faster. You've just got to use brain.
Didn't land. so important for these two fighters because it allows them to use their skills throughout the match. It can all come down to who's in better shape.
It can change. It can change their attitude. It can change their nervous system for a certain amount of punches per round. Because otherwise, if they deviate from the game plan, they're going to be shattered once again, and the fight will be over.
Ground still up for grabs with just 10 seconds to go. There is no doubt about who won that round.
Dominance, without a doubt, Nate looks.
There's the bell for round six. There is no doubt about who won that last round. Let's see what he has for us here in the next one.
He's going to throw the kitchen sink at you. You've got to be ready for that. Don't fight fire with fire. Hold him up. Be smart because he's going to try and put you on the paper. He knows your legs are gone. He knows your legs are tired. He's sharp.
Fighter, but that doesn't always mean success. How many times have you seen a fighter chase a superior athlete around the ring and just get picked apart, even though they were the one pushing the tempo?
Some kind of aggressive fighters like this, they are a nightmare. If you are not fit, that is the worst place to be. Have second thoughts in the ring.
They go.
For I am the truth. I am the light that lighteth every man and woman that cometh into this continent, into this world of America today.
It's time for the talking to stop and the fighting to start. This should be good. I'm Todd Grisham. Alongside me is Johnny Nelson.
Looking forward to this one, Todd.
It's time for our tale of the tape. Muhammad Ali, the greatest of all time. 6'3" tall, the best to ever... Roy Jones... It's here, and the fighter. These athletes have promised us a war. Let's see if they deliver. Perfect counter shot. Then step back for just a moment. Showing exceptional chins, by the way. No rest for the weary. I missed with that jab. And then we'll strike like a snake. Keep an eye on this guy. Watch it. Set the time at the blink of an eye. They wait to see any difference what you do. So you better fight a counter punch is smart. He misses with that jab. You know the scorecards are going to be all over the place in this one. That's a counter punch.
Complacent and think this is too easy as they took this 10 kind of concept, they've got this fight.
Round. Let's see what he has for us here in the next one. Trying to keep his elbows tucked into the chest so he can avoid the pain of those body shots. But that leaves more opportunities for headshots. Positives and negatives in the heavyweight division are the same. You can win the fight with one punch, and you can lose the fight in one punch.
I've seen it so many times, one punch changes everything. As Ray hands down,
secret who has the advantage after that last round. Let's see what they have in store for us in the next one. Let's get it started in round three. Coming off that fantastic last round. Let's see if he can keep his momentum going. Step back for just a moment. Perfect counter lands. You can tell he's stronger, but he's not faster. Tough to be a judge in this fight, as both fighters have had their big moments. This fighter's certainly not going to outthrow their opponent by any means, but they will, when they hit, be a lot harder.
This could be really intimidating, Todd. If you know somebody's got the punch power, someone's got the speed, someone can take you out with a simple jab, it can be intimidating. It just depends on how confident you are as a fighter.
Good counter-punching for both these athletes. Misses with the left uppercut. This round can go either way. 10 seconds to go. Talk about a one-sided group. There's the bell for round four. There was no doubt of who won that last round. Let's see what he has for us here in the next one.
I agree. The ref knew exactly what he was doing. So you know what? Great shout. I look forward to fight number two.
Hello, fight fans. I'm Todd Grisham. Welcome inside the Grand Theater. Alongside me is Johnny Nelson.
Hi, Todd. Nice to be here with you.
Time for our tale of the tape. Tyson Fury. He stands an imposing 6'9" tall with a reach of 85 inches. And across the ring from him, Muhammad Ali. He stands 6'3" tall with a 78-inch reach. The Gypsy King himself, Tyson Fury. We welcome you to this beautiful show Could be a good one. You couldn't write a script like this. This is like Rocky versus Apollo. Left counter was perfectly timed.
You've got to take them out of their pace. Do not wait for them, because if you wait, they'll pepper and pop you all night long. Rush them.
Gotta like what you're seeing as we reach the halfway point of this round. Both men step back for just a moment.
Round. Now you've got to make sure he doesn't put it on him. That's what he's going to try and do. So tie him up, hold him, lean on him. Don't get drawn into a fight. Not yet. Not until your senses have come back.
When someone punches that hard, you don't want to trade shots. Left counter score. Back for just a moment. Perfect counter lands. Punch, counter punch. He just missed his next right hand. These two heavyweights decide to exchange punches early or decide to box a little bit.
I've seen it so many times. One punch takes seconds. It's like the showboat shot and bang! It's over. So they've got to stay sharp. One punch changes everything.
Close round with 10 seconds to go. Catch and shoot. And a round that seemed like eternity for them finally. On to the third. Safe to say that last round was a nightmare. Let's see if we can turn it around here.
Now he knows he's been hurt. He's going to come out and put the pressure on. He's going to throw the kitchen sink at you. You've got to be ready for that. Don't fight fire with fire. Hold him off. Be smart, because he's going to try and put you under pressure. He knows your legs are gone. He knows your head's not cleared. Be sharp.
Punch will score. I'd like to see more jabs.
speed. It's so hard. It's not so bad.
Starting to heat up now as we enter the fifth. Coming off that fantastic last round, let's see if he can keep his momentum going. How nervous would you get when you know you're facing a big puncher like this guy that can seriously hurt you?
I've seen certain fighters that can depend on just their power alone. Forget tactics. They know the second they touch you, it's done. That's where the power comes from.
Halfway through the round, and I don't know who's got the advantage. Great stuff. You can tell he's stronger, but he's not faster. You hear people talk about a boxer's chin. Do they have a good chin? Do they have a glass jaw? Those are questions that are being answered here tonight.
What a gift it is to have a chin where you know you can do anything and everything. And we let those shots go. It's just bouncing off and everything. It's so demoralizing. It's a great job. What else can you do?
keep us here in the next one. Strategy. Those punches are doing nothing. He misses with that jab. That jab misses. Confidence do you build when your opponents hit you with their best shot and you walk right through?
The problem with having a chin that everybody knows if they hit you, you're hurt, you're gone. You've got to protect that, but you've also got to get your shots off. And don't forget, you can bang too.
Can't believe we're only halfway through the round.
Situations you just be hurt, you could have been there again. Be smart, be sharp, don't be afraid, don't get sucked in. Make you fight, your fight.
Hold in time, get into your head crazy again, and your legs come back to you. Because if you don't, you can pop you up.
This fighter can go punch for punch. There's resistance to these blows, just isn't the same.
I've seen some fights with a granite chin. You can hit them with a sledgehammer, they are not going to move. But then I've seen some mad punches with a chin like that. I've seen the chuck and they're gone. And this is the dangerous thing.
Just back for just a minute. he's stronger, but he's not faster.
Thank you.
progress here.
Change it. An excellent last run. Everything works. Wait for the reaction. Until then, keep doing what you've just been doing. Because you've won it. I'm done.
Thank you.